Well, hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm out on one of the other trails that I like to go to near my place. It's near a reservoir. You can see down here we've got a nice reservoir body of water there, and on this particular trail I've got tree fall here. Now I've got a pretty robust bike. It's an e-bike. It's a CyRusher XF900, and you can see I've got it set up with my WORX chainsaw. It's a 40 volt system. It's got an 18 inch bar that I've upgraded on it. I've got it mounted to the bike here. This is called a saw press, which can mount to the bike. You need to clamp it down to something like the bike rack in the back. Holds it pretty secure. The extra weight is a consideration for when you're riding the bike, because that extra weight will take you and shimmy you back and forth. But today what we're going to do is we're going to attack this log here. Now this log that's blocking the trail is pretty substantial. I'm going to guess he's, you can see my finger span's 9 inches. That's going to be about 18 inches across. And then up the trail further there, you can see there's some more logs. So here we go. All right, so I'm going to show how I secure and unsecure my chainsaw. I've got a pair of bungee cord, or a set of bungee cords right here, that I use to help stabilize the saw. This backpack here, it's got my extra batteries in it. I'm carrying two on the chainsaw and an extra four inside my bag. So the first thing I got to do is just unscrew this clamp here. Okay, got that unscrewed. And I've got a little bungee cord holding my scabbard on. Take him off. Secure him. Okay, I'll get him in a bit. All right, so my strategy here is, what I want to do is take a piece of this tree out that's going to be easy for me to roll, because I'm here by myself today. So I'm looking down underneath the chainsaw. I've got a like a branch that came off at one time, so I'm going to make a cut there and a cut back there. That way I can at least get by on the trail here. All right, so this one's going to pinch at the top, so I'll make my top cut first. I see this one's closed up a little bit and that one opened up, so that tells me I should be good to continue here. Yep. All right, happy time. Just got to roll him out. I'm gonna save this for later. Yeah, I thought an old guy like me would be able to move that little bit of log, but apparently it's got some dampness in it that's making it a little harder to roll. Plus it's got bumps in it at the bottom. So one thing, I don't mind doing the work, but I don't want to kill myself in that process. So I'll save this for my next ride back here when I have some other riders with me. But in the meantime, I'm going to hike up here to this set of trees. All right, so just a quick check here. I still got about half my battery left. And because this guy's wanting to fall down that way, I think I'm going to make a cut here. Reposition a little bit. So what I want to do is, because this is leaning down, I want to make a cut where it's easier, so I'm going to make a cut here. I'll make a, let's see, I can make an undercut first and then the top cut last. And that way I can come in here and probably cut this guy about here and move him okay on my own. Tell that that cuts a little harder, because even though it's a poplar tree, it's a still living tree. So I've got my cut here, I made the exaggeration on. Go to the other side. I'm worried about there's a branch up above there that might come get me. That could have went worse. Okay, we're good there. Alright, so I'm gonna make a quick cut over here. Get him out of here, he should be good to go. Down. Alright, so now we're going to turn our attention to this guy over here. He's a little more problematic as well. All right. Alright, so I got a lot of cutting done there with that original set of batteries, but just for this last one here, I want to show maybe an action shot of how the close-up of the cutting here goes. So, not too bad. Alright, well that's really all I have time for today. So I've got basically three sets of downfall here out of the way. So I'll come back and get that sorted out with some other riders I ride with back here later. Okay, time to get back on the bike. These scabbards, you know, I think are definitely worth it. It's a little bit of a hassle using them, but the downside is they're pretty expensive. But you know what? I found them from eBay. They're pretty cheap. So just a tip for folks to try. Keep yourself a little safer. My little bag here. Loop it up here as secure as I can, but that's not really enough, is it? Hence the extra bungee cord. All right, pretty secure. All right, well, thanks for watching, everybody. That wraps up this video where I didn't do too much, but I think I got about an 18-inch log here cut. For, again, friends of mine are going to come along and help me roll that guy out of there. And some tree fall up the trail a little bit. As for doing this here, I guess I could have made a cut, but that's enough to get by for now. We'll leave that for another adventure. I'm sure up the trail further, that goes on another 3 miles that I know of. I'm sure there's going to be more tree fall up there that I'll encounter, so the plan is to get that done. All right, thanks for watching, everybody.